Nous allons parler de biodiversité ordinaire.
We're now going to talk about ordinary biodiversity. What is ordinary biodiversity? A very simple definition consists in saying that it is the biodiversity that surrounds us. But there is also a more conceptual definition. It is what corresponds to ordinary species, species which are neither endangered nor domesticated nor exploited, approximately 80% of the species present on Earth, more than 1.5 million species, a huge number. What are the dynamic data regarding biodiversity, ordinary biodiversity? Birds are the species on which we have the greatest dynamic data quantity because we have ornithologists who observe the birds. There are monitoring systems in many countries. In France, we have the STOC, the temporal monitoring system for common birds, providing data on the dynamic situation of the 125 species of known birds on the national territory. And we see, for instance, that the skylark is declining, that the blackbird is stable. Very quickly, we have a vast quantity of data based on which it's difficult to have an integrative vision allowing us to understand what is happening. So what we do is that we group the species and we look at the dynamic data of bird communities. When talking about ordinary biodiversity, we're interested not so much by the species, but by the community of birds. Communities are groups of species which are close, similar for ecologic reasons. They have the same function in the ecosystem, and they have also evolutionary similarities, an ancestor which is not too far remote. Birds can constitute communities, and in bird communities, there are birds who specialize in urban environments, forest environments, or agricultural environments. We have observed in France and in most OECD countries that the birds who specialize in the agricultural spaces are the community that is not doing well at all. This is what you see on the graph. Although most birds are slightly declining, the decline is quite obvious and marked for birds specializing in agricultural landscapes. Ordinary biodiversity is therefore not doing too well for birds, and this is all the more marked in the agricultural landscape. What about the other groups in ordinary diversity? We are getting some data on insects. For a very long time, it was difficult to document the evolution of insects, but now we have enough data to observe that insects are declining and that 40 to 50% of insect species are seriously declining. We can also have a look at other groups. Corals are declining as well, generally speaking. We can also look at other species depending on the place they occupy in the food chain, primary producers, plants, algae, herbivorous animals, carnivorous animals, and both in the marine environment and in the terrestrial environment, we see that the species at the top of the food chain, marine carnivorous animals and terrestrial carnivorous animals, are declining more than the others. And this obviously has functional consequences because it leads to destabilization of the food chain. Another trend observed is the tilting of the oligotrophic environments in marine systems, aquatic systems, rich in oxygen and fishes, environments where water is clean and which are now tilting towards eutrophic environments invaded by bacteria and toxic and microorganisms, environments where there is not enough oxygen and very few fishes can be found. Another trend has been observed regarding biodiversity, ordinary biodiversity, the response to global warming. We have observed changes in the phenology, the data which major events happen in the life cycle, reproduction, for instance. Insects will emerge sooner, earlier in the spring. The buds will grow earlier on plants, and bird eggs will hatch earlier in the spring. And there is a difficulty regarding adjustment between birds, insects, and trees. There are also birds going up northbound because they are trying to follow their thermal preferences. And because the climate is warming up, birds are moving up northbound. Now, what I find remarkable regarding species movement is that it's not synchronous. If you observe butterflies and birds in Europe, the birds will change 1 to 2 kilometers a year, whereas insects and butterflies will go up north 5 to 10 kilometers per year. And this is obviously worrying because birds feed on butterflies, and some of those butterflies are pests for crops, and therefore they escape predation, and this has agronomic and forestry consequences, which may be very detrimental for the ecosystem. Now, to summarize the stakes regarding ordinary biodiversity, there are 5 types of stakes. First of all, the intrinsic value of ordinary biodiversity. It is its own value, not because these species are not endangered and about to disappear doesn't mean that they should not be preserved and don't have an intrinsic value. And also, ordinary biodiversity is the habitat for a number of endangered species. Some prey that the endangered species feed on are often species that belong to ordinary biodiversity. Now, if the biodiversity, ordinary biodiversity, were to be wiped out, then endangered species could no longer survive. The third stake is that the ordinary species are also the habitat for human beings, and this environment is being damaged. Finally, another reason to contribute to the preservation of biodiversity, the evolutionary potential, the appearance of new species will happen not so much from endangered species with a very low evolutionary potential, but rather from species belonging to ordinary biodiversity. And finally, ecosystem functionalities depend essentially on ordinary species. The ordinary species are absolutely essential for the good functioning of ecosystems and human societies. In conclusion, the take-home message is that ordinary biodiversity is a central element for biodiversity and that its future should be a major concern for human societies.